Will Sipho ever be redeemed? I don't know.
Yes.
Hi everybody, welcome
yes.
back
Oh,
to
yeah.
my channel. My name is Kulufelo Mayineja, and if you don't know, here we are writing 1,000 words every day for 100 days. So yesterday, chapter 9, I ended the chapter with a huge bang that made me feel so good. Yes. So today I want to talk about the effects that writing have on a writer, on the author themselves. I might be the one who's writing the book, but it also affects me. Emotionally, you get affected as the author because you do care about your characters. They are part of you in a way that, like, I can't explain it. It's almost like when I, as the author, you are the, I want to say the creator, but you are the creator, because when you say the creator, you think of God, the all-knowing, but you are in this sense. So as God cares for us, you also care for those characters, and they do affect your mood. As I've written a sad book, sad, gut-wrenching, I will cry, even I would cry, I'm sure I cried when I was writing it, a type of story a long time ago. So right now I don't write those stories anymore because I am not in that space anymore. So it's almost like when, as the author, you write what you feel. It's almost like it's a reflection of who you are as well. So most of the novels that you would read, they do have parts of the author's emotions in them, because nothing comes out of a vacuum. Everything is there, is created, you know. So everything that the author puts in and they create in that story, it's something that they've experienced. But those emotions that the characters feel, you do feel as well. And alone, for you to write those emotions, you have to dig deep within yourself. You have to become what the character is in order for you to describe, make the character relatable, give readers a glimpse of this person that's, it's unreal, but it's in a way real, you know. They become real because you make them real. You give them the emotions, you give them the heartbeat. So that heartbeat also affects you as well. So sometimes that's why it's not surprising that you will find out there are certain authors who become depressed because of their work. It's not that they are depressed but not themselves. Is the work that they have to do and the journey that they have to walk with the characters that they write. It's also draining as well. That's why yesterday I was so happy when it ended. I was like, yes, there's a good moment. We can celebrate now. We can feel happy because the character feels happy as well. You know, it was a happy moment that also made me happy. I was so happy. For her and for myself, you know, it was a break from the sadness and the heartache and the crying and, you know. So if your emotions are invested, the story becomes so powerful because it comes from a real space. It comes from a real beginning. That is you, the author, you know. So you are literally giving people, readers, you're a part of you, and that feels good and nice. Just then, don't get too depressed while you are writing your story. From there, after she won the money, what is she deciding to do? She's celebrating with her mom. Everything is fun. Finally, she's seen the light. Things are not as bad as she thought they were. Well, they are still bad, but they're not bad in the sense that she got lucky. Her money is back. Maybe she'll think of starting that business that she wants, which is where I want her to go. I want her to remember that she had a goal, you know. And if we can focus on that goal and forget about other people, maybe we might just win. But you know, life, you know. Ah, you like umjolozo, yeah. And also, remember when she went to the casino, she left what's his name again? Sipho and Amahle together. So that whole vibe over there, like, I have a thing that I have in my mind now that I'm thinking about, and I don't know, like, I'm not sure if it's a good idea or not. So the thing is, I want Ulo, remember Amahle just open is going to open a case against Sihle, right? And then she wants to get her fired from her job, right? I want her to kind of like convince Sipho to stay with her, like in a relationship, to get in a relationship with her. Because right now, they are not in a relationship. We are not sure, are they in a relationship or they are not in a relationship? We are not sure so far. But I kind of like want them to get together for Amahle to blackmail him into getting into a relationship with him. And the blackmail is that she's going to drop the case if he does that. So for me to do that, I'm wondering if I should bring a perspective, yeah, Amahle, because at least we've ended the whole thing on a high note with Sihle, you know? So the perspective might stop there, gaslighting, yeah, Sihle, and then I could swing to Amahle's side and have her view of the whole thing. Or will it be drastic? Because this is chapter 10. I do remember saying, I don't remember when I was talking about perspectives and stuff, I was saying, will it be too late to switch perspectives, or should I remain with Sihle's perspective and we see everything from her side of the story or not? That's why I'm not so sure. But it could still come out later on. It could still. Because then if we don't know, it will make for a good read. Why would... Yeah, it could. Because why would Sipho date Amahle if not to make Amahle stop the whole opening a case thing, you know? And also and then Sihle could find out later on. It could make for a good read. I don't know, like, I'm not sure if switching into like point of views will be a good idea right now, right here, because it's a bit too late. Chapter 10 is too far for you to suddenly just, well, for me, I feel, I don't know about other people, I feel, for you to suddenly just switch. Okay, let me just see where I can take it. It would be so nice for it to be a secret that Amahle blackmailed Sipho into the whole date me, I'll drop the case type of thing. And then we find out later. It will be a nice reveal later on in the book. I don't know. Let's see. Okay, so I've reached my goal for today, and yeah, it's quite good. So, like I said, the plan is she's going to open her shop, and yeah, and Amahle dropped the charges. Sihle heard that from Lulu, the manager of the shop. So now she knows that, okay, Amahle dropped the case. Like I said, I'm planning to have like Amahle, barking, what's the word? Blackmail Sipho to do it. So, but Sihle doesn't know that right now. And the way it's going, I'm not sure. Like I said, it is a romance, but it's also very traumatic. What? Those things. So it's not like that. Those sweet romance, happy ever after type of thing. So while I was writing, I don't know, like I am going between the fact that I want her to get back with Sipho after the whole mess that's gonna happen throughout the book. But I'm not so sure. Should I introduce a new character, a male character, the one that's going to be the love interest, or should I just wait and see how far I can take it, like with the whole thing? Will Sipho ever be redeemed? I don't know. Like, so far, especially with that bit that I just said that I want Amahle to blackmail him, will he ever be? Because if she dropped the charges, then it means that he agreed with her. Like, that's the plan. So he's going to date her in order for Sihle not to lose her job. But then Sipho doesn't know Sihle resigned. By the time he knows, maybe he would have hooked himself somehow. Like, I will find a way to get him tied to Amahle, because it could be like she blackmailed him but also told him to. Yes, I think that's where it's gonna go. So in the coming days, maybe that's what I'm going to build towards, like that whole thing. Yeah, betrayal, like that whole thing. Yeah, he's trying to save Sihle, but then Sihle resigned as well. So what's her name? Maybe Amahle will know that Sihle resigned, but keep the whole thing to herself. Because if Sipho knows, then it means that the whole blackmail thing won't work. So I don't know. It's still in the air. I'm not sure, especially about introducing a new character and stuff, like a male character that would just bring a different dynamic to the whole thing. But I feel like I should hold on and see where it could go. But I'm not so sure. I'm not sure. Like, I'm really not sure. I'm really not sure. I don't like characters who, like, main characters who hate their love interest. I don't like that. Like, for me, you can never redeem yourself, especially in a romance novel. Like, you should be perfect. Dude, it's romance, it's fantasy. Why are we hating each other in novels that are not real? That's my take on it. I don't even like the body with Whitney Houston and Kevin Costner's movie. What was it called? The bodyguard, my bodyguard, that I don't even like it, because the ending, like, really, does he really have to go? Does he? I Doesn't make sense to me. I don't like it because of that. He didn't have to go. They could have been together. Now we had to sing a song about heartbreak and all these other things. I don't like that. So, like, I don't know. Like, I feel like there will be it take bringing in a male interest will be an easy way out for me, because then I would write, then the heartbreak will stop, and then we'll concentrate on the love part, you know, between Sihle and the new guy. We'll work on it, and they will be in love. You know, she's doing her business, she's succeeding, they have a minor problem here and there, and then their love flourishes, and they are together forever and ever. Amen. But that's the easy way out. That's the easy way out. That's like the typical love story, you know. She got dumped by her ex. He was not good, and then she found another man. That's the easy way out. So I'm not sure if I should. The way it's going, I don't know. It's becoming really complicated for some reason, and I'm not sure. We'll see. We'll see. What should I do? Tell me. What should I do? We'll see. Comment and tell me what I should do. But anyway, goal is met. I'm done for today. Day 9 is done. See you tomorrow.